This is how I insulated my trailer.
Okay, here's the finished product. Here's how I insulated my trailer. I live in Arizona. This is the end of May. It was 111 degrees outside at 4 o'clock. I had both air conditioners running, and inside temperature in my living area was 97 degrees. On the other side of this pop out, slide out, is a cupboard above my, in my kitchen area. It got so hot that my bottle of olive oil in that cupboard started to melt. So I knew I had to do something. So this is what I came up with. I got 1x4s and foam board, and I took the 1x4s and I painted them with Thompson water seal, and I screwed them to my trailer, 3 screws in each board, 4 foot on center. I put the foam board on and I sandwiched the 1x4 on top of that, creating a 3/4 inch gap between the foam board and the trailer. And then I painted it. And on the sides here, see, most of the heat was coming from the sun beating down on these metal frames, the slide outs, metal frames. On the inside, without the protection here, I could barely put my hands on the metal frame. It burned my hands. That's how hot it was. And it was just radiating that heat inside the trailer. So I cut foam on the sides of my pop out, slid it in the gap here, and I got lucky there's a little edge right here on the side of this slide out that holds this foam in. Now this foam is not screwed in or wired in, it's just put in there and it stays. It was super windy the other day with 40 mile an hour gusts and it has not moved. It moves back and forth like this, but it doesn't come out. So I painted it because the reflection was like a solar oven. So I painted it and I cut out, obviously, from my refrigerator vents and my window and my docking station. Now I also insulated the top. I put insulation board on top. I used bricks to hold it down. That was my idea, and it doesn't look bad. And the next day, with both air conditionings running, at 4 o'clock, it was 80 degrees. I dropped it down 17 degrees by doing this.
Thank you. Thank you.